Good morning all of you. Welcome to e-classes. Now today we are going to continue with the topic which we are doing yesterday, that is characteristics of poetry. So we have already known about two characteristics. As I have told you all that there are five characteristics of poetry, and two already we have discussed, and today's topic is figurative language. That means the third characteristics of poetry is figurative language. So let's start with our class. Figurative language is often found in the poetry. The following types of figurative language are often seen in poetry. That means figurative language is often found in a poetry. That means figurative language is always, not always, sometimes oftenly it has been found in the poems which we are reading. Okay, the following types of figurative language are often seen in poem. These are the types of figurative languages which we found in the poetry. The first type is simile. Simile is a figurative type of language. Okay, compare two things using like or as. That means simile is a type where two type of things or figures are being compared. Like or as, you will have to put like a girl, as a girl, like this. So it's an example over here. The girl is like a, that means like a here is comparing with what? Like a tornado. Okay, now here you can see like, that means it has been compared by tornado on the basketball court. Okay, let me tell you that here you can see like is what here, that means like is comparing, simile, comparing with something. Okay, so the girl is like a tornado. Here you can compare a girl with a tornado on the basketball court. So this type of poems, this type of figurative type, simile type, is a figurative language which is used by the poet. Now the second type is metaphor. Comparing two things by saying one thing actually is another thing. Okay, that means comparing two things. You have to compare two things by saying one thing actually is another thing. Whatever thing is there, that actually is something else over there. The girl is a tornado on the basketball court. Now see, this line and this line are almost same. The thing is that simile will compare with by saying like, and here you cannot see anything like that. The girl is a tornado. That means the girl is really a tornado on the basketball court. Clear? Now the third type is personification. Personification, giving human characteristics to a non-living thing. That means giving something in that poem, giving something, a person or something to a figuristic view. That means human characteristics to a new living thing. Clear? Giving human characteristics to non-living things. That means something is there which is human characteristics are giving non-living things. The autumn leaves dances across the street. Now in this line you can see that the autumn leaves, okay, the autumn leaves is danced. The autumn leaves danced across the state. Clear? In this example you can find that humanistic characteristic. Who dances?
A human character.
Okay, now the autumn leaves danced across the street. Now it's changing to a non-living thing. Clear? Danced by a human characteristics, but it has been changed over there. So hope this topic is very much clear to all of you. Today's topic was figurative language, and that is the third characteristics of the poetry. Hope you understood. And if you do, and if you have any doubt, you can ask me in the class. I'll surely explain you and make it clear to you. Thank you very much. Take care of yourself and be at home, and take care of yourself and your family too.